CIET NCERT presents audiobook of social science for class 6 titled Social and Political Life 1 Unit 3 Local Government and Administration page 49 chapter number 6 titled Rural Administration. There are more than 6 lakh villages in India. Taking care of their needs for water, electricity, road connections is not a small task. In addition to this, land records have to be maintained and conflicts too need to be dealt with. A large machinery is in place to deal with all this. In this chapter, we will hear about the work of 2 rural administrative officers in some detail. There is a picture given on page number 49. In this picture, there is a drawing of 2 farmers made who are quarrelling with each other. Another farmer is looking at them. Some women and men are working in the fields in the background. It is written below the drawing, a quarrel in the village. Mohan is a farmer. His family owns a small agricultural field which they have been farming for many years. Next to his field is Raghu's land, which is separated from his by a small boundary called a bund. One morning Mohan noticed that Raghu has shifted the bund by a few feet. By doing so, he had managed to take over some of Mohan's land and increased the size of his own field. Mohan was angry, but also a little frightened. Raghu's family owned many fields, and besides, his uncle was also the sarpanch of the village. But even so, he plucked up courage and went to Raghu's house. A heated argument followed. Raghu refused to accept that he had moved the bund. He called one of his helpers, and they began shouting at Mohan and beating him up. The neighbors heard the commotion and rushed to the spot where Mohan was being beaten up. They took him away. He was badly hurt on his head and hand. He was given first aid by one of his neighbors. His friend, who also ran the village post office, suggested that they go to the local police station and file a report. Others were doubtful if this was a good idea, because they felt they would waste a lot of money and nothing would come out of it. Some people said that Raghu's family would have already contacted the police station. After much discussion, it was decided that Mohan would go to the police station along with some of the neighbors who had seen the incident. Page number 50. There is a picture drawn on page number 50 of a police station. Mohan can be seen talking with the police officer. Area of the police station. On the way to the police station, one of the neighbors asked, "Why don't we spend some more money and go to the main police station in the town?"
"It is not a question of money. We can register the case only in this police station because our village comes in its area of work," explained Mohan.
"Every police station has an area that comes under its control. All persons in that area can report cases or inform the police about any theft, accident, injury, fight, etc. It is the responsibility of the police of that station to inquire, to investigate and take action on the cases within its area. There is a box given here on page number 50 with 4 questions in it. The questions are, 1. If there is a theft in your house, which police station would you go to register your complaint? 2. What was the dispute between Mohan and Raghu? 3. Why was Mohan worried about picking a quarrel with Raghu? 4. Some people said Mohan should report the matter to the police, and others said he should not. What were the arguments they gave? The work at the police station. When they reached the police station, Mohan went to the person in charge, Station House Officer or SHO, and told him what had happened.
He also said that he wanted to give the complaint in writing. The SHO rudely brushed him aside, saying that he couldn't be bothered to waste his time writing down minor complaints and then investigating them. Mohan showed him his injuries, but the SHO did not believe him. Mohan was puzzled and did not know what to do. He was not sure why his complaint was not being recorded. He went and called his neighbors into the office. They argued strongly that Mohan had been beaten up in front of them, and had they not rescued him, he would have been injured very seriously. There is a yellow box given on page number 50, which says, "Show the above situation in the police station through a skit. Then talk about how you felt playing Mohan's role or that of the SHO or the neighbors. Could the SHO have handled the situation differently?" They insisted that the case be registered. Finally, the officer agreed. He asked Mohan to write down his complaint and also told the people that he would send a constable the next day to investigate the incident. Page number 51. Maintenance of land records. You saw that Mohan and Raghu were arguing heatedly when the common boundary of their fields had been shifted. Isn't there a way by which they could have settled this dispute in a peaceful manner? Are there records that show who owns what land in the village? Let's find out how this is done. Measuring land and keeping land records is the main work of the Patwari. The Patwari is known by different names in different states. In some villages, such officers are called Lekhpal. In others, Kanungo or Karamchari, a village officer, etc. There is a picture drawn on page number 51. In this picture, a Patwari or a village officer is seen taking down notes after talking to two villagers. We will refer to this officer as Patwari. Each Patwari is responsible for a group of villages. The Patwari maintains and updates the records of the village. The map and the corresponding details from the register on the next page are a small part of the records kept by the Patwari. The Patwari usually has ways of measuring agricultural fields. In some places, a long chain is used. In the above instance, the Patwari would have measured both Mohan's and Raghu's fields and compared them with the measurements on the map. If they did not match, then it would be clear that the boundary of the fields has been changed. There is a yellow box given here on page number 51, which says, "Find out the term used for the Patwari in your state. If you live in a rural area, find out how many villages does the Patwari of your area maintain land records of? How do people in the village contact him or her?" The Patwari is also responsible for organizing the collection of land revenue from the farmers and providing information to the government about the crops grown in this area. This is done from the records that are kept, and this is why it's important for the Patwari to regularly update these. Farmers may change the crops grown on their fields, or someone may dig a well somewhere. And keeping track of all this is the work of the Revenue Department of the government. Senior people in this department supervise the Patwari's work. Page 52. The note on this page reads, "The Khasra record of the Patwari gives you information regarding the map given here. It identifies which plot of land is owned by whom. Hear about both the records and the map, and answer the questions given here regarding Mohan and Raghu's land." A yellow-coloured Khasra record is given here. In this, there are various columns titled Area in Hectare, Name of the Owner, Father or Husband's Name, Address, if the land has been rented to someone else, the area cultivated this year, the crop grown, area, second crop grown, and areas not cultivated below, and also a column for writing the facilities. This page is called a Khasra record of the Patwari. This gives us many informations about the map, who owns the land south of Mohan's field. 2. Mark the common boundary between Mohan's and Raghu's lands. 3. Who can use field number 3? 4. What information can one get for field number 2 and field number 3? There is a map given here, which says Village Amrapura, Patwari record number 16. The map shows which direction is north. There is also a legend given here, which says which sign is for a boundary, a well, a grassland, a kacha road, a pakka road, and a tree. On this map, the land has been divided in various plots. Page number 53. All states in India are divided into districts. For managing matters relating to land, these districts are further subdivided. These subdivisions of a district are known by different names such as tehsil, taluka, etc. At the head is the district collector, and under her are the revenue officers, also known as tehsildars. They have to hear disputes. They also supervise the work of the patwaris and ensure that records are properly kept and land revenue is collected. They make sure that the farmers can easily obtain a copy of their record, students can obtain their caste certificates, etc. The tehsildar's office is where land disputes are also heard. There is a yellow box on page number 53, which says, farmers often require a copy of their land's record together with a map, as has been given in the previous page. They may have to pay a small fee for this. However, this information is not easily made available, and farmers sometimes have to face many problems to get it. In some states, records are now being computerized and also kept at the panchayat office so that they are more easily available and regularly updated. When do you think farmers may require a copy of this record? Study the following situations and identify the cases in which these records would be necessary and why. A farmer wants to buy a plot of land from another. A farmer wants to sell her produce to another. A farmer wants a loan from the bank to dig a well in her land. A farmer wants to purchase fertilizers for his field. A farmer wants to divide his property among his children. There is a picture drawn on page number 53. In this picture, there are total 4 members of a village shown. There is a boundary which is made here. On one side of the boundary, 2 men are standing. On the other side of the boundary, 2 women are standing. One of the women is saying, I want a place of my own, not dowry. There is a poem given on page number 53. The title of the poem is A Daughter's Wish. Father inherited our house from his father, and everyone says he leave it to brother. But what about me and my mother? To expect a share in my father's home is not very womanly, I am told. But I really want a place of my own, not dowry of silk and gold. The source of this poem is Reflections on My Family, written by Anjali Monteiro, TIS. Page number 54. A New Law, Hindu Succession Amendment Act 2005. Often when we think of farmers who own land, we think of men. Women are seen as people who work on the fields, but not as people who own agricultural land. Till recently in some states, Hindu women did not get a share in the family's agricultural land. After the death of the father, his property was divided equally only among his sons. Recently, the law was changed. In the new law, sons, daughters, and their mothers in Hindu families can get an equal share in the land. the same law will apply to all states and union territories of the country. This law will benefit a large number of women. For example, Sudha is the eldest daughter of an agricultural family. She is married and lives in a neighboring village. After her father's death, Sudha often comes to help her mother with the farming work. Her mother has asked the Patwari to transfer the land and enter her name along with the names of all the children in his record. Sudha's mother confidently organizes the farming with the help of the younger brother and sister. Similarly, Sudha also lives with the assurance that if she ever has a problem, she can always depend upon her share of the land. There is a yellow box given here on page number 54, which says, Other Public Services, a Survey. This chapter has looked at some of the administrative work of the government, especially for rural areas. The first example related to maintaining law and order, and the second to maintaining land records. In the first case, we examined the role of the police, and in the second, that of the Patwari. This work is supervised by other people in the department, such as the Tehsildar or the Superintendent of Police. We have also seen how people use these services and some of the problems that they face. These services have to be used and made to function according to the laws that have been framed for them. You have probably seen many other public services and facilities provided by various departments of the government. Do the following exercise for your village, or by visiting a nearby village or looking at your own area. List the public services in the village or area, such as the milk society, the fair price shop, the bank, the police station, the agricultural society for seeds and fertilizer, the post office or sub-post office, the Anganwadi, creche, government school or schools, health center or government hospital, etc. Collect information on three public services and discuss with your teacher how improvements can be made in their functioning. One example has been worked out. Page number 55. There is a table given here on this page. In the first column, it is written public service. Three public services have been mentioned in three different rows under public service. These are fair price shop or ration shop, health center, milk society. There are six columns apart from this column. The headings of these columns are: What did you notice about their work? Area covered. What do you need to do in order to use the facility? Problems faced by those managing the service. Problems faced by people. Improvements that can be made. The activity is to collect information regarding these headings and write in front of the respective public service. The information about observations on the fair price shop or the ration shop have already been filled here as an example. These read, The shop was open. Three people came. They all had yellow cards. They bought sugar and rice. Kerosene was not available. This shop covers two villages. They need a ration card. This has to be made at the tehsil office. There is not enough supply of kerosene. Rice is of very bad quality. We never get kerosene. Improve quality of rice. Make kerosene available. The fair price shop should be kept open every day. Like this, you have to fill the information about the various headings regarding the two other public services, that is, the health center and the milk society. Page number 56. Questions. 1. What is the work of the police? 2. List two things that the work of a Patwari includes. 3. What is the work of a Tehsildar? 4. What issue is the poem trying to raise? Do you think this is an important issue? Why? 5. In what ways are the work of the Panchayat that you heard about in the previous chapter and the work of the Patwari related to each other. 6. Visit a police station and find out the work that the police have to do to prevent crime and maintain law and order in their area, especially during festivals, public meetings, etc. 7. Who is in charge of all the police stations in a district? Find out. 8. How do women benefit under the new law? 9. In your neighborhood, are there women who own property? How did they acquire it? The chapter number 6 ends here. Narrator, Vaibhav Srivastav. Producer, Vandana Arimardhan. This chapter was presented to you by CIET, NCERT, New Delhi, India.